Uncertain if you're in the right place. Please get your seats. Don't rush. Don't trip. Don't fall. How are you guys? I just want to test something. Put your right hand like this. Put your left hand like this. And then go like this. People are doing it. I love the people who define me. Okay, put your right hand like this. Put your left hand like this. But follow me. I want to stress the people out looking for their seats. Okay. There's enough of you in your seats. We're Tegan and Sara, and we're gonna play The Con in full. Here we go.
So long.
Two hands.
So, we're here to celebrate the 10th anniversary of our record, The Pod. Some of us are celebrating more than others. And then after we complete the 14 songs from The Con, we're gonna play you songs from a bunch of our other records as well. Some of them are records that people liked as much as The Con, and some of them are the records that people wrote online about how much they hated. that's a good smattering, like we really showed no, we didn't favor anyone, you know?
We just decided, you know what, fuck it. We're just gonna play the songs that you guys want, and then also do a set of songs that we really like a lot.
That's great. I mean, so far so good. It's been a great week.
So far everyone's been pretty positive. We only had one audience breakout in booing. Just kidding, as if you guys. That's psychotic. That would never happen.
So, who here has seen us before? Who here has not seen us before? Really interesting.
Yeah, cool.
Well,
you're gonna love it.
Yeah, you're gonna have a great time. We're a ball. We recorded The Con in Portland. Yeah. We came here for three unusually wintry months in the winter of 2007. No, because I think it was like January, February, March, and then we put it out in October 2007. So 2007. We figured it out.
We did it, and we didn't even have to look at Wikipedia.
Yeah. So we came here, and we lived in the Northeast. We lived two blocks from the Kennedy School. Yep. And we had a great time. We actually really liked Portland. We had a lovely time.
What? The only thing I don't remember liking is that the guy that lived across the street from us, he
had suffered some kind of injury where his head was bandaged and he had a puppy and a gun, and it was intense, to say the least. Lots of yard wandering.
A lot of intense.
And we would turn all the lights off in the house that we rented, and we would be like in the darkness watching him wander around. But I don't remember really being that frightened, but
really?
I do. We had, you know, it was different. We had different. But anyway, the point is we love Portland.
We love you too!
We enjoyed our time here, and we mostly remember the time of recording as positive, but it is an anxious record. There's a lot of sad songs. I know there's some young friends who I saw on the internet who are here tonight. Hi guys, nice to see you again. So we're gonna try not to be too dark and bleak, which is probably a positive thing. They should probably plant young people in the audience front row every night for the next month. Because it was a really anxious record. You'll learn more about the kinds of anxieties we were going through as you get older. So I think I tried not to fuck them up and then did right away, like just right away. But you know, because you've been to concerts, you know.
Do you know what though?
You came full well knowing what was gonna happen. So you're
not,
fine. You don't even look stressed out. You look amused.
It's not your first rodeo.
It's her first.
Yeah.
But okay. Okay.
But how?
You're an old pro. Welcome to the first Tegan and Sara concert. We'll try not to mess you up too bad.
How old are you?
They're
11. 11? So, I mean, at 11, if I told you what I was about to begin doing, and I won't. But like by 11, I had read like every V.C. Andrews and Stephen King novel, so. Yeah, no, for sure. I understood the world
at
11 as well as I understand it now at 37. Like I knew everything. I didn't yet know how to exactly place it. Like, have you read V.C. Andrews? Are we, don't let them read V.C. Andrews. That's how The Con is really, like, that's really the nucleus of that album is Flowers in the Attic. It's,
actually, no, it's really not.
Obviously, it's not, I'm just saying.
No, actually, you just were like, that's literally the, like, actually, no. Flowers in the Attic is about a very disturbing thing we're not going to talk about, and that's quite literally the opposite of what this record is about.
I just mean...
Oh my god, no, stop for a second. Just hold on. Did you know that Sarah's three times your age? Tegan could have had you. Oh, my kids. Tegan could have had you, and also you, like, Tegan could have had you, and then you could have children, and then she would be a grandparent in, like, 5 years. Like, in 5 years from now, you could make Tegan a grandmother, and that would be, everyone, come on, that would be amazing. So, okay. We've played two songs. So, we're gonna...
You started it, you said...
No, I was just giving, I was saying hi, because I had seen the photo of you guys on your way here, and was like, oh, so cute. I didn't, like... So, we're really excited to be in Portland and play the pod for you, and yeah, we're really excited because the shows have been going great, and this next song is called Encircle Me, but Sara renamed it The Con, which is fine. But I was looking at the session at home recently, and it's called Encircle Me, so.
Before you had a chance to forget, forgotten, now you're moving past this game.